I'm But I have no other choice but to trust God. Is there anybody here that feels like I do, that you have no other choice now but to trust God? I found out that everything that God allows to happen in our lives, and even in society, they were never designed to destroy us, but they were designed to build us up better. I wish I had somebody that felt like I do. They have been designed to make us better, whether it's your job, whether it's your home, whether it's your children, your health, whatever it's been there for a reason. Now I want to do this disclaimer out right now. God has not allowed what to happen to punish us. He's just growing some of us up. Some of the things that are happening in our world, He's just pulling us up in this season that we're in. See, I've discovered that there are some things that have happened this year already that have increased our prayer life. Is there anybody that's prayed more this year than they have ever prayed in their lives? Some things have happened in our lives that have caused us to stop putting so much trust in other people and start trusting God more. Can I get a witness in here? We have put our trust in the wrong people, places, and things, and after they disappoint us, we have literally found ourselves walking away from God. When we need to be walking toward God, we need to be walking in His presence, we need to be walking in His mercy. And see, we've got to understand that some things were necessary. Touch your neighbor, tell them, some things were necessary. Look at somebody, tell them, some things were necessary. I know you cried. I know you wanted to punch a hole in the wall. I know you wanted to do some things and even say some things, but it was necessary for your growth as a believer. I used to think it was just a cliche, but they used to say the things that won't destroy you will make you stronger. But I found out for myself that the things that didn't destroy me have made me stronger. I learned how to trust God. Is there anybody in here that has learned how to trust God in spite of the circumstance? Trust God in spite of what everybody has faced. Trust God in spite of all of the calamities that are coming up in your life. You've got to learn how to trust in God. But what happens in most cases, if you're not careful, those things that don't make you better will make you bitter. The things that don't make you better will make you bitter. And the problem with that is, the things that make you bitter will not bring glory to God. See, I've discovered two things in this 9 years, and in order for God to get the glory, we've got to give Him the glory. In order to give Him the glory, we've got to take our hands off of Him. In order to give Him the glory, sometimes we've got to close our mouths. In order to give Him the glory, we've got to stay out of His way. Can I get a witness in here? You've not only got to go through it, but you've got to grow. See, we're trying to just go through this thing, and God is getting us to a place that we've got to learn how to grow through it. Can I get a witness in here? See, your sole purpose for going through it ought to be stronger in God. See, I've discovered that when you go through something, if you come out of it weaker than when you came in, you weren't trusting God through the process of it. If God allowed you to go through it, you ought to be stronger on the other side of it. I wish I had about 20 people that know that if God brought you through it, He'll surely see you through it. You just got to grow through it. God text this morning is one that we've read down through the years, but God showed me something significant as we enter into this season of recommitment. One of the greatest things we have as a believer is a relationship with God. I'm not talking about religion, I'm talking about a relationship with God. And I've discovered that having one is one thing, but maximizing that relationship is another. Touch somebody and tell them, you've got to maximize your relationship with God. And my brothers and sisters, that relationship is one that's personal. It's one that has nothing to do with your neighbor, has nothing to do with your pastor. That relationship is between you and God. And we find ourselves thinking that we're hurting God when we don't worship. We're hurting God when we don't praise Him. We hurt God when we don't come to fellowship. We're not hurting God. And this text tells us about David, even in his act of adultery, and how he needed God to do something in his life that only God could do. And that was to restore him. That was to recommit him. That was to bring back the joy of David's salvation. David said in the text, created my neighbor.
Yes. Yeah. Thank you.
Church is open. Come on, let everyone experience it.